In the north of Ireland, there's a crowd of fellas called Orange Men. If I come down to you, I'll hiss you and tell you. There's an Orange Man over here. Anyhow, this is a song about a fellow who was an Orange Man. In the north of Ireland, they're the bad fellows and we are the good fellows, and they have big rows and parades and everything on 12th of July every year to commemorate the crossing of the River Boyne by King Billy. Now, we didn't care too much for King Billy, and we still don't care too much for King Billy. But just to prove we're not prejudiced, I'm going to sing an Orange song. It's about this fellow, Bob Williamson, who played a flute in this parade, and he was an Orange Man, but he did the unthinkable thing. He married a Papist. And he never had a day's luck since. And the name of the song is The Old Orange Flute. In the county Tyrone, near the town of Dungannon, where many's a ruction, myself had a hannin', Bob Williamson lived, however betrayed, and all of us thought him a stout orange blade. And the 12th of July, as it yearly did come, Bob played with his flute to the sound of a drum. He may talk of your harp, your piano, or lute, but there's none could compare with the old orange flute. But Bob the deceiver, he took us all in. He married a papist called Bridget McGinn, turned papish himself and forsook the old cause that gave us our freedom, religion and laws. Now the boys of the place made some comment upon it, and Bob had to fly to the province of Connaught. He fled with his wife and his fixins to boot, and along with the latter his old orange flute. At the chapel on Sunday to atone for past deeds, said Paters and Aves and counted his beads, till after some time at the priest's own desire, he went with the old flute to play in the choir. He went with the old flute to play for the mass, but the instrument shivered inside, oh alas. And try though he would, though it made a great noise, the flute would play only the Protestant boys. Bob jumped and he started and got in a flutter, and threw the old flute in the blessed holy water. He thought that this charm would bring some other sound, when he tried it again it played Croppy's Lie Down. And for all he would whistle and finger and blow, to play papish music he found it no go. Kick the Pope and boiling water it freely would sound, but one papish squeaking it couldn't be found. At the council of priests that was held the next day, they decided to banish the old flute away. They couldn't knock heresy out of its head, so they bought Bob a new one to play in its stead. Well, the old flute was doomed, and its fate was pathetic. 'Twas fastened and burned at the stake as heretic. As the flames soared around it, they heard a strange noise, as the old flute still whistling the Protestant boys. Torally, torally, oh, it's 6 miles from Bangor to Donaghadee.